You've probably heard of manual focus and autofocus, but what are all the differences between full auto, spot, area focus, continuous versus single modes? In this video, we are breaking it down to simplicity, talking all things focus modes, what the different focus modes on your camera means, and how to easily choose the right one for what you're shooting. Welcome back to the series, Everything I Learned in Photography School. You're currently watching lesson number 3. Check out the channel to see all the lessons where I share my knowledge of everything I learned in photography school through my undergrad and master's programs in quick and easy 10-minute lessons. I post 3 new lessons a week, so remember to subscribe to my channel to get the lowdown on everything I learned in photography school. Getting back to the focus of this video. Focus modes. In episode 1, we talked about exposure and camera settings, but exposure is only one part of the camera settings that you need to know to be able to take great photographs. Have you ever shot an image where the camera just wouldn't pick up exactly where you wanted the focus to be, so in the image it ended up being blurry or with the wrong parts sharp? That's the most frustrating thing. But choosing the right focus mode or manually focusing your camera can be a big help with this. The different focus modes work in different ways, so depending on what you're shooting, you're gonna have to play around with the modes and figure out what is the best focus mode for your shoot. Some say the best way to focus your camera is to turn off your autofocus completely and manually focus by moving the ring on your lens around until you get the perfect focus point. While this is great in some instances, it's very difficult to do if you are moving holding the camera or if you're shooting a fast-moving subject. It also takes a lot more time to carefully manually focus. I generally prefer autofocus using spot points in my photography. Depending on your camera, you'll have different options within the autofocusing realm. Different cameras will have different focus modes, areas, and points to choose from. I'm going to talk about the main ones, and once you know these, you'll easily be able to understand any additional focus modes your camera might have. So let's talk about focus options. Option number 1. Full automatic focus. In full automatic focus, you're letting your camera do all of the work. In this mode, your camera will choose a point or a group of points and guess which part of your image should be in focus. The downside to this mode is that more often than not, the camera will not focus on the part of the image that you want to be in focus. It's really frustrating and you end up moving around a lot and pressing halfway down a bunch to try and refocus when really you could have gotten the shot right away by choosing a different focus mode. I don't recommend shooting in full automatic focus really at all for anything because you may as well just be shooting your camera in full auto at that point and you're not going to get the focus that you want and in turn you're probably not going to get those creative shots that you want. Option number 2 is spot focusing. When you select spot focus, you take one focus point and move it around to any point in the viewfinder. When you select the point that you want to be in focus, then the camera knows, and it will focus directly on that point to make it sharp. Different cameras will have different ways to choose your focus point. Some cameras allow you to choose the amount of predetermined points and how they're arranged in the viewfinder. You can then select one of the points you want to focus on. These predetermined focus points often look like little squares dotted around the viewfinder. Other cameras allow you to move your focus spot to anywhere around the field of view. Usually, when you have this option, you'll use a wheel or a movable button to move your focus spot around the viewfinder. Option 3, area focus modes. Area focus modes are like a combination of full autofocus and spot focusing, but they both have disadvantages and advantages. Area focus mode, unfortunately, combines both. When you select area focus mode and look through the viewfinder, it generally looks like brackets or squares that cover a larger amount within your field of view. Similar to a focus spot, you have the ability to move the brackets of the focus area around slightly, but your entire subject that you want to be in focus has to be within the focus area. Area focus modes give you a wider area to focus on rather than one specific spot. But on the other hand, area focus modes use the camera's intelligence to determine what points within the area brackets are in focus. The points it selects may not always be what you wanted to be in focus. Area focus mode is much better than full autofocus, but it can still sometimes choose the wrong points within the area brackets that you want to focus on. I only really recommend using area focus if you're trying to focus on one or more things within a larger area. Now, besides choosing the spot or the area which your camera focuses on, you have to choose also the way your camera focuses. And these ways are either called continuous or single mode. Choosing between continuous and single focus modes is different than choosing your focus spot or choosing your focus area. So this is a different selection within the focusing. When you select single focus mode, you press halfway. The camera focuses on your determined spot or area, and the focus is set. You then press all the way down to take your shot. Single focus mode is great for shooting products or a subject that's not going to be moving around too much. I always use single focus mode in the studio when I'm shooting still life because I know once I've focused halfway down that nothing is really going to be moving too much, so I go ahead and take the shot. When you select continuous focus mode, your camera will continually try to focus on the spot or area you determined until it becomes sharp. If your subject or you move out of focus and there becomes a blur, the camera will start again trying to focus on that spot until it becomes once again sharp. Continuous modes are great for moving subjects. Some cameras have better continuous focus than others, being able to track a subject without going too much out of focus. Some cameras, like my Sony, even has face detect, where it will latch onto a face and lock on that face, and if you move, it won't go out of focus. I actually use my Sony camera with face detection to take all my self-portraits and to film all of my videos. It really gives you a peace of mind knowing that even if you're moving a bit, you're not gonna go out of focus too much. No, this video is not sponsored by Sony. To recap, focus types are full automatic, spot focus, and area focus. Full automatic focusing lets the camera do all the work and chooses what to focus on. You have zero control with full automatic focusing. Spot focus gives you the option to choose one specific spot out of a number of predetermined spots that you see within your viewfinder. Some cameras allow you to move the spot anywhere within the field of view. Area focus mode gives you a larger bracket or area which you can slightly move around the viewfinder. In area focus mode, the camera determines what point or points within the area to focus on. You have control over the larger area, but not the exact points which will be in focus within that area. Focus modes are single and continuous. In single focus mode, you press halfway down on your shutter and your focus is determined. If you move with your camera or your subject moves, you're gonna have to refocus again. In continuous focus mode, your camera is constantly tracking or trying to focus on the point or area which you've selected. What you are shooting and your shooting style will ultimately determine the focus mode you choose. I hope this was able to explain focus modes clearly for you guys and you're able to choose what's best for you. Check out the channel to see all the lessons where I share my knowledge of everything I learned in photography school through my undergrad and master's programs in quick and easy 10-minute lessons. I post 3 new lessons a week, so remember to subscribe to my channel to get the lowdown on everything I learned in photography school. Before we sign off, I would love to see you all on Instagram, and you can follow me at Gabrielle Ruddick for all the latest. As always, please feel free to drop a comment below and let me know, what focus modes do you guys use most often? See you in the next lesson of Everything I Learned in Photography School.